Hello students, welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit Pravinya. In today's lecture, we are going to start exercise 14, which is based on the same chapter. Okay, so see here, in this exercise, we have problems based on calendar, okay, and calendar and time. Now see, the first problem in exercise 14, open your Xerox page number 103. First problem is, this year the summer vacation was from 2nd May to 12th June inclusive. How many weeks did the vacation last? Means how many weeks there was a vacation, that we have to find. Okay, the vacation started on which date? 2nd May. Okay, 2nd of May. And vacation ended 12th June inclusive, the word inclusive given for that this 2nd May and 12th June are included in the vacation, means school will start on 13th June. Okay, till 1st May there was school, 2nd May onwards vacation started and it ended on 12th June, and from 13th June onwards school started. So this 2nd May and 12th June, these two dates are included in the vacation. For that the word inclusive is given. Okay, now see, we have to find that how many weeks vacation was there, okay, or how many weeks did the vacation last, means how many weeks there was a vacation, that we have to find. Means this from 2nd May to 12th, how many weeks? That we have to find, okay. So see here, first what we will do, directly we will not find weeks. First we will find days. How many days are there from 2nd May to 12th June? How many days are there? So in this see, 2 months are there, May and June. Okay, May and June. So in this vacation, how many days we are getting in month of May? See here, for example, I am giving here. See, this is May month. Can you see? This is May month. Vacation started on 2nd May. Here. Okay, from here, that means only one day of May is excluded, not counted. So 2nd May to 31st May, how many days we will get in the month of May? Total there are 31 days in month of May. So vacation started on 2nd May, that means only one day is not will not be counted. So we will get 30 days of May. Okay, 30 days of May for the vacation. Then in June, we have month June. Now in month of June we have vacation till 12th June, that means 1 to 12, how many days? 12 days. Okay, so total how many days? Total days of vacation, total days of vacation, 30 plus 12, how many? 42. Okay, so we have, or the vacation is of 42 days. Now this 42 days we will convert into weeks. You know, 1 week means how many days? 1 week has how many days? 7 days. Correct. So 42 days is equal to how many weeks? 42 divided by 7. We will divide this 42 days by 7 days. So that we will get number of weeks. 42 divided by 7, 7, 6 are 42. So the vacation is of 6 weeks. Okay, 6 weeks. Understood? Next. Example number 2.
See now, example number 2, question number 2. For question number 2 to 6, one common instruction is given. Refer to the calendar for May 2005 given earlier and solve question number 2 to question number 6 using the same. See on previous pages one calendar is given. See here on page number 94. See this calendar. Table 2, May 2005. This is the calendar of May month of 2005. Okay. So, we have to observe the details of this calendar, of this month, and we have to answer the questions given there. Question number 2 to question number 6. Now, see here, what is question number 2? On which day and date was Buddha Purnima? We have to find day and date of Buddha Purnima. Now, see here, on this page, Buddha Purnima 23. Buddha Purnima 23. So see, where is 23? Here. Correct? 23. And which day is there on 23? See here, Monday. Okay? So, what we'll write Buddha Purnima was on Monday 23 May. Okay? Next, third one. How many days did Buddha Purnima occur after Akshaya Tritiya? How many days after Akshaya Tritiya Buddha Purnima occur? Okay, so see here when there is Akshaya Tritiya. Akshaya Tritiya is on see on this. Here they have given holidays. Akshaya Tritiya is on 11th May. Okay. And when there is Buddha Purnima? Buddha Purnima is on 23. Means after how many days? After how many days of Buddha Purnima occur after Akshaya Tritiya? Okay. That we have to find. Now see, Akshaya Tritiya is on 11th of May and Buddha Purnima is on 23rd of May. To find that, we have to find what? We have to find difference between these 2 days. 23 minus 11. So 3 minus 1, 2. And 2 minus 1, yes, 12 days. After 12 days, Buddha Purnima occur after 12 days than Akshaya Tritiya. Okay? That means what? See, if you add 12 in the 11, you will get 23. Means after 12 days, there is Buddha Purnima. How to find? Find the difference between the days. Dates of Buddha Purnima and Akshaya Tritiya. That is difference of days you will get. Understood? Next. Fourth one. What is the difference in days between the two holidays, that Maharashtra Day and Akshaya Tritiya? Akshaya Tritiya, see, you know Akshaya Tritiya is on which day? Akshaya Tritiya is on 11th. And Maharashtra Day, everybody should know Maharashtra Day is always on 1st May, that is one, okay? Maharashtra Day is observed on 1st of May every year. So what is difference between these? What is the difference between these two dates? Means what? Between these two dates, how many days occur? What is question C? What is the difference in days between the two holidays, that Maharashtra Day and Akshaya Tritiya? That means between these two dates, how many days occur? That we have to find. So see, Maharashtra Day is on 1st. Maharashtra Day is on 1st of May here. And Akshaya Tritiya is on 11th. So between this 1 and 11, how many days occur? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 and 10. Okay? Means, see, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Between 1 and 11, how many days occur? 9 days. So, between Akshay Tritiya and Maharashtra Day there are 9 days. Understood? We do not have to find difference of this date and this date. 11 minus 1, no. We have to find between these two dates how many days occur. That is 9 days. Okay? Means Maharashtra Day is on 1st May. Okay? And next holiday is Akshay Tritiya. It comes after how many days? After 9 days. Okay? Now see, next question. Fifth one. See, fifth one question. If today is 30th May, if today is 30th May, that is 30 May, okay, today there is, date is 30th May. How many days earlier was full moon day? Full moon day means in Marathi what do we call it? Purnima. Okay? Purnima. So full moon day was on, it is given in the calendar. Full moon day was on 23. See, both the Purnima is there, no? 23. On that day there was full moon day. It was on 23. 23rd May. So they have asked, before how many days, if today is 30th May 2005, how many days earlier means before, there was a full moon day. That means we will find the difference in these 2 days, dates, 30 minus 23, 10 minus 3, 7, yes, 0, 7 days. So full moon day was on 23rd of May, that is before 7 day. Or before 7 days from today, okay? Before 7 days. Understood? Today is 30th May, full moon day was on 23rd. And so it was before 7 days. Understood? Okay, you can count this by orally also, not need to subtract. You can count orally also, okay? Now write these 5 questions. After that, we will see few more questions. One more question is there, see. Question number 7. Question number 6, which is based on the calendar only. Write down the names of the weekdays. Write down the names of the weekdays that occurred 5 times during the month. 5 times during the month. Now see the calendar, which days are occurred 5 times. See here, Sunday, there is Sunday on 1st May, 8th May, 15th May, 22nd May and 29th May. It is 5 times in that month. Also Monday, 2, 9, 16, 23 and 30, there is Monday. And Tuesday also 3, 10, 17, 24 and 31. Okay, so 3 days, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, these 3 days are occurred 5 times in that month. Rest all days are 4 times, okay, if you will observe. Understood? So see, whenever the month is of 31 days, 3 days occurs 5 times. Whenever the month is of 31 days, 3 days occur 5 times. And here Sunday, Monday and Tuesday are occurred 5 times. So here answer of our 6th question, I write here. Question number 6, Sunday, which days are occurred 5 times? Sunday, Monday and Tuesday. They are not asked dates, so we will not write, only days we will write. Okay. Now pause this video and write these questions till 6. Two more questions. Both the questions are based on the time watch. Okay. Question number 7.
A train leaving Mumbai today at 8:45 a.m. will reach New Delhi tomorrow at 3:40 p.m. How much time will the journey require? The journey is from Mumbai to Delhi. Okay, and the journey is by train. Okay, now see the train leaves Mumbai means depart from Mumbai at what time? 8:45 a.m. You know a.m. and p.m. a.m. indicates morning, means before 12 noon, and p.m. indicates after 12 noon to night, midnight 12, okay? And after midnight 12 to noon 12, there is a.m. a.m. is morning, p.m. is afternoon and night, okay? Now see, train depart at 8:45 a.m. and leaves Delhi at, means today, 8:45 a.m. today, and reached Delhi at 3:40 p.m. tomorrow. It is tomorrow, not today. It is very important. Today and tomorrow is very important. 8:45 a.m. is today in the morning. 8:45 a.m. it started. It depart from the Mumbai. Okay, and tomorrow 3:40 p.m. means in the afternoon. Tomorrow in the afternoon, it reaches to New Delhi. Then we have to find how much time it takes for this journey. What is the duration of this journey, that we have to find. Pay attention very carefully. It is very easy, but pay attention carefully. Now see, when there is today and tomorrow, directly we cannot find the difference between these two times. Directly we cannot find, because if both the times would have today's, means if it has left Mumbai at 8:45 a.m. today and it has reached Delhi at 3:40 p.m. today, then directly by doing subtraction we will get. But here departure time, leaving time is 2 days, 8:45 a.m. today, and reaching time is 3:40 p.m. tomorrow. Okay, so see here what to do in this case. Leaving time is 8:45. So 8:45 a.m. today to 8:45 a.m. tomorrow. See now, 8:45 a.m. today, it is starting time. Hours will be there. How many hours will be there? See, whenever, see, today 10 a.m. to tomorrow's 10 a.m. How many hours will be there? One whole day, that is 24 hours. Today 12 noon to tomorrow 12 noon. 24 hours, that is one day. Okay? So here 8:45 a.m. today to 8:45 a.m. tomorrow. How many hours will be there? 24 hours. Understood? Today 8:45 a.m. to tomorrow 8:45 a.m. 24 hours. So now we have reached till tomorrow 8:45 a.m. Okay? Now, tomorrow, and here also reaching time is also tomorrow. That is 3:40 p.m. Now this reaching time, which is 3:40 p.m., we will convert into 24-hour clock. You know, 24-hour clock we have seen last year. 24-hour clock means 3:40 p.m. means it is after 12 noon. Okay, after 12 noon. So in 24-hour clock, see, 12 midnight to 12 noon. We count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 12. Okay? But after 12 noon,
After 12 noon, which if there is 1 hour, 1 o'clock, then it will be counted as 13 hours. Then 2 o'clock, it will be counted as 14 hours. 3 o'clock, it will be counted as 15 hours. Likewise, 4 means 16 hours. 4 p.m. means 16 hours. 5 p.m. means 17. 6 p.m. means 18. 7 p.m. means 19. Okay. Likewise, the day has 24 hours. So till midnight 12 again, there will be 24 hours. Understood? So here 3:40 p.m. means we will convert that 3:40 p.m. into 12-hour clock. 3:40 p.m. means it will be is equal to 3 means 15 hours. That means 15:40 hours. Okay. Now see, 8:45 a.m. today to 8:45 a.m. tomorrow, 24 hours. Fine. Now we will find now duration between 8:45 a.m. tomorrow to 15:40 hours tomorrow. 8:45 a.m. tomorrow. If you want to convert this 8:45 a.m. in 24-hour clock, it will be, as it is a.m., that means it is 8:45 a.m. only, 8:45 hours only. Understood? Because it is a.m. in the morning, we count as usual, 1 to 12. If it is a.m., it will remain as it is, 8:45 hours. If it is p.m., then it will change, because 3 p.m. is 15 hours. Okay? It is in the afternoon. Understood? So now we will find difference between this duration. That is difference. Okay? So your 40 minus 45 again, seeing that this is hour column, this is minute column. Now we will do the subtraction. Now see, in minute column there is 40 minutes here 45 minutes. Now 40 minutes minus 45 minutes, not possible. Okay? So what we will do, you know, from this R column, 1 R will take borrow here, 1 R. So when 1 R will come in the minute column, it will change into minutes. You know, 1 R means how many minutes? 60 minutes, correct? So when 1 R will come in the minute column, it will change into minutes, that is 60 minutes. So these 60 minutes we have taken borrow from R column and this 40 minutes. Total there will be 0 and 6 and 4, 10, 100 minutes. Okay? And this 15 hours will remain 14 hours. 1 hour we have taken borrow. Understood? Now 100 minus 45. See again, 0 minus 5 not possible. So 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 4, 5. And 40 minus 8, 6. 6. 55 hours. So this is duration of tomorrow's. Tomorrow 8:45 a.m. to 3:40 p.m. tomorrow. Okay. So total how much duration, total time of journey is 24 hours. Today 8:45 a.m. to tomorrow 8:45 a.m. these 24 hours plus tomorrow 8:45 p.m. and to the final reaching time 3:40 p.m. that is 15:40 hours. So that our duration is 6:55 hours. Okay. So total time will be 24 hours means 24 hours 00 minutes. So it will be 55 minutes and 24 plus 6 30 hours 55 minutes, that is 30.55 hours. Okay, this is the total duration, total time taken for that train for the journey. Understood? Once again I repeat, pay attention very carefully. See, leaving time is today's, departure time is today's, that is 8:45 a.m. today in the morning. Okay? And reaching time is tomorrow's 3:40 p.m. not today's, tomorrow's 3:40 p.m. Okay. So here, when there is today, living time is today's and reaching time is tomorrow's. In that case, what to do? You know, 8:45 a.m. today to 8:45 a.m. tomorrow. 8:45 a.m. today to 8:45 a.m. tomorrow. Total 24 hours that we have found here. And from tomorrow's 8:45 a.m. to final time 3:40 p.m. we have found here duration. First we converted both the times into 24 hour clock and then we subtracted that, we got 6 hours 55 minutes. Means from 8:45 a.m. tomorrow to 3:40 p.m. tomorrow, total duration is 6:55 hours that we added in the 24 hour. Total duration is 3 hours 55 minutes. Okay, in this we have to find. Next, 8th one. My watch gains 2 minutes per hour, per hour. Okay, I set it correctly at 10 a.m. today. What time will it show at 2 p.m. tomorrow? Understood this? My watch gains 2 minutes per hour. Means what? It is not working properly. It is running ahead. Okay? It is not working properly. It is running ahead. Means its hands are not working properly. So for every 1 hour, it gains 2 minutes. Gains means it is ahead by 2 minutes. Okay, means if normal clock there is suppose 9 o'clock, then in my clock it will be 9 hour 2 minutes. Okay, 9 hour 2 minutes. If it is in normal clock it is 10, then in my clock it will be 10. Here to add there again 2 more minutes 4 minutes in this way. So now for every 1 hour it is gaining 2 minutes. 2 minutes are increasing ahead. Understood? So if I set my watch at 10 a.m. today, I set watch 10 a.m. What? 10 a.m. today. Again, see, there is matter of today and tomorrow. Okay? I set my watch 10 a.m. today. What time it will show at 2 p.m. 2 p.m. tomorrow. 2 p.m. tomorrow. Okay, again there is today and tomorrow. 10 a.m. today, 2 p.m. tomorrow. So first, what we will do? Per 1 hour, the clock is gaining, sorry, watch is gaining 2 minutes. Watch is going ahead by 2 minutes. Okay. So, 10 a.m. today to 2 p.m. tomorrow, whatever hours will be there per hour, it will increase by 2 minutes. Okay. So, total, how many hours are there? That we will find first. To find the time, it will show at 2 p.m. tomorrow. At 2 p.m. tomorrow, what time it will show? To find that, first we will find how many hours are there. What is duration of this time? And that hour will be multiplied by 2, because per 1 hour it is gaining by 2. It is increasing by 2 minutes. Okay? So now see, again same like this. 10 a.m. today to 10 a.m. tomorrow. How many hours are there? 10 a.m. today to 10 a.m. tomorrow, how many hours will be there? 24 hours, correct? 24 hours. After that, 10 a.m. tomorrow to 2 p.m. tomorrow, how many hours? 10 a.m. tomorrow to 2 p.m. tomorrow, how many hours?
Sorry, tomorrow spelling is wrong.
Okay. 10 a.m. tomorrow to 2 p.m. tomorrow, how many hours? 10, after 10, 11, 12, 1 and 2, 4 hours, okay? 4 hours.
So total, what is total time? Total duration or total hours? Total hours 24 plus 4, 28 hours. This is first we have found the duration between 10 a.m. today and 2 p.m. tomorrow. Total there are 28 hours. Okay. Now, since watch gains means increased 2 minutes per hour. Means per 1 hour, it increased by 2 minutes. Now, for example, I have said at 10 a.m. today. So at 11 a.m. today, it will show 11. In normal clock, it will show 11 a.m. But in my watch, it will show 11 hour 2 minutes. In normal clock, it will show 12 hours or 12 noon. But in my watch, it will show 12:04. That is 12 hours 4 minutes. In normal watch, it will show 1 o'clock. At that time, in my watch, it will show how many minutes? 1 hour, 6 minutes. 2 hours increasing per 1 hour. Okay? So 2 minutes increasing. That means it will show 1 hour, 6 minutes. Okay? So, likewise, within these 28 hours, how many minutes it will gain? So, watch gains 2 minutes per hour. So, it will gain 28 in 28 hours. Minutes in 28 hours. How many? 1 hour, 2 minutes. So in 28 hours, 28 twos are, that is 56 minutes. 56 minutes are not completing 1 hour. So it will remain minutes only. Okay. If it there would be more than 60 minutes, then we have counted hour and minutes. Now see, it will gain 56 minutes. Understood? So the question is, when there will be 2 p.m. in normal watch, when there will be 2 p.m. in normal watch, what time will my clock watch show? Okay, my watch will show what time? So at 2 p.m. tomorrow, my watch will show what time? 2:56 p.m. Means 2 in normal clock watch there will be 2 p.m. In my watch there will be 2 hours 56 minutes. That is 2 hours 56 minutes. Okay, p.m. Understood? Why? Because per 1 hour it gains by 2 minutes. Per hour 1 hour it increases by 2 minutes, it go ahead by 2 minutes. Okay, so there are 28 hours between 10 a.m. today to 2 p.m. tomorrow. So within the 28 hours, it will go ahead by 56 minutes. Understood? This is when it is possible, when the watch is not working properly. Okay, so today we have seen this eight questions of the exercise 14. Question number 2 to 6 were based on the calendar which is given in the textbook, and this question number 1, 7, and 8. That we have solved here. Okay, so I hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt, ask during the doubt session. Okay, so thank you for today and have a nice day.